Yo, Cup of Joe, back again with another Splatoon 2 video. Earlier this week, I showed you guys my aggressive Neo-Sploosh-O-Matic build, and now, today, as promised, I'm going to be showing off the passive Neo-Sploosh-O-Matic build. The strategy starts off the same way. You want to make sure to have beacons on the map to help your team get back into battle. Then, instead of throwing yourself at the enemies like with the aggro build, we're going to be taking things a lot more slowly, taking safe positions, and focusing more on turf control. Having some Ink Saver main and Ink Recovery up is pretty core to this strategy. You want to be playing very safely and draw out fights for as long as possible. You want to force the enemies to run out of ink. And with your Ink Saver main and Ink Recovery up, you are going to still have some gas left in the tank when they need to reload. And this is your moment to take easy turf control. You're also going to want to be taking some swim speed into battle. This is to help you move faster and stay alive, which will further enable you to play passively. Of course, I had to include some special charge up into this build. It's going to help you to apply more pressure by giving you more Tenta missiles and giving you more ink tank refills from using your special, which again helps you to apply more pressure. I decided to squeeze that swim speed and ink saver main all onto the hat in order to free up the main gear slot on the shoe because I want a shoe exclusive ability. The one I'm going with here is Object Shredder. Now this is something you only need to add to your build in reaction to what's happening inside of the metagame. If you don't know what the metagame is, it's the game outside of the game. So things like what weapon you choose, what gear you choose, what hair you give to your character are all a part of the metagame. What gear you choose should be partially influenced by what weapons you're expecting to see. So if you're noticing that enemies on a certain map are always trying to use bubbles to force the Rainmaker through a choke point or using a baller to force their way under your clam basket, then you can react by adding some Object Shredder into your build. This would be you countering the metagame. However, if you are not noticing any situations where having Object Shredder would have helped you win a game, then don't bother putting it into your build, just replace it with something else. I wanted to make sure to include Object Shredder into my recommended build, just so that there's something in there that you can easily just take out if you don't need and replace with something that you want more of. Also, on the shoe, very important, we got Sub Power Up. This makes it so that anyone on your team can jump to any of your beacons faster. Squid beacons alone do a lot to help a team to continuously apply pressure, and having sub power up just makes that even stronger. All of the gear abilities that you see in this build, you really can't go wrong with. Except, of course, for Object Shredder, which you only want to use in reaction to things you notice about the metagame. But everything else in this build, you can feel free to add more of it, use less of it. You could even try using Run Speed up instead of Swim Speed if you feel that that is going to help you more to stay alive. And when you're just starting out, go ahead and pick the three gear abilities I've recommended which appeal most to you. Make those your three main gear slots and then just build up from there. With this build, you really need to be paying a lot of attention so that you can be playing safely while still contesting some turf. And if you pull that off well, then you will be rewarded with some moments where, like I said, your enemies will have to stop shooting and start recovering, but with all of your ink efficiency in your build, you're going to be able to keep on going and take control of some turf for free. That is the more difficult side of this strategy, but the easy part is just inking turf, spamming Tenta missiles, and making sure to have beacons on the map. I recommend this build for Splat Zones and Turf War. I want to go back to that aggro Neo Sploosh build that I showed you guys on Monday. The nice thing about the Neo Sploosh is that the main weapon doesn't really rely on having very many gear perks in order to make it strong. So even without all of the ink efficiency in the aggro build, you still have the option to play passively. While on this specifically passive build, you don't really have the option to play aggressive because you have no quick respawn as a backup. However, the upside to this more passive build is that it gives you a stronger reward for playing passively correctly because you're going to have more special charge ups, so that means more specials obviously, and you have more ink efficiency, which means when you're playing passively you're able to get a better reward in the end once the enemy finally runs out of ink. I would also like to let you guys know that last Friday I did a Twitch live stream where I tested out these builds and tried to collect some gear chunks to get the perfect set of sub abilities. It was a lot of fun hanging out with you guys, and now I'd like to do it again this Friday, which is actually today. So tonight at 7 p.m. Pacific time, I'm going to be investigating the next weapon that I would like to create some builds for, and I'm probably going to be continuing to do these investigations on topics I would like to make videos about on each Friday. If you're interested in seeing the cheese get made live, then be sure to tune in at twitch.tv/yocupofjoe. Links in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed what you saw here. Feel free to leave a comment if you have a question or a suggestion. Thank you for watching. Bye!